Matthew, how are you doing?
Hi, how are you?
Just fine. Hey, you're here. We're not live right now, but okay. You're here with Will Payne and Barry Diamond and me.
All right.
It's a,
how are
it's
you
a,
folks?
It's a real pleasure to speak.
Good morning for you. It's good evening for you down here.
Good. Right. Hey, was your Friday okay? Are we looking for a good day?
Oh, yes, yes. Everything's fine.
Okay, good.
What about
you? Well, we're hoping that, you know, you've already experienced your Friday, so we're hoping ours is equally as well.
I'm sure it'll be.
What's the weather going to be like today?
Well, it's always hot, you know. Singapore is always hot. It's kind of same like before. You know, sometimes it pours, but today has been pretty fine, sunny.
Okay, so we're going to expect sunny and hot. Okay.
All right.
Yes.
Sunny and hot for the rest of the day, guys.
We're probably around 32 degrees or somewhere around there.
Yeah, Celsius.
It's Celsius, yeah.
I'm going to say, here we say 32. Man, that's cold. All right, here we go. Stand by.
Here we go.
From Nashville, Tennessee, where all year long the summer breezes blow. And while my friends are flying kites and planting bonsai trees, I got high on country radio.
It is K95.5's WB Morning Circus, Will Payne.
And Barry Diamond.
And Howard Houchen.
And Howard, we have a special guest, the Singapore Cowboy, with us.
Yes, the Singapore Cowboy, Matthew Tan. Now, Matthew, how are you
thank
doing
you.
Today?
I'm fine, thank you. And it's good morning to you guys out there.
Yes, good. It's good morning here, and I have to say good afternoon to you. You're about 13 hours ahead of us.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's nighttime now.
Good evening. Good
yeah,
evening.
Yes, good evening. Yeah.
Good evening to him, and good morning to us. And
the sun has long gone.
Well, you know, we want to welcome you onto the show. You know, Howard introduced us to your music, and, you know, there's a great story there. You know, you were able to bring traditional country music to Singapore.
Yeah, I've been doing this a long time. This is going to be next year will be my 50th year of being a professional entertainer, musician.
Now, when you got started, was there anyone doing country music?
Well, there was, but very, very little. You know, our radio was pretty small. You know, we never have any kind of a showcase or anything like that. You know, we were still very much run and governed by the English British government, and very rural where I used to live, and hardly any radio shows much. We do have that radio station that we're still having, but at that time it was just one station catering to news and all kinds of programs, mixture of everything, you know.
Right.
Never really have any kind of program that just played country music per se, you know.
Wow.
Now,
it's kind of mixed back.
Now, Matthew, one question that I have for you, and you've answered this, but I want the listeners to hear it. You know, there you are. You were basically, born right at the end of the Japanese occupation of Singapore. And
that's right.
You're growing up, and you like to say, you grew up Ulu, you know, in the kampongs, and, you know, and for reference, that's very poor, and you kind of liken it to, you know, Loretta Lynn and her... coal miner's daughter. You grew up poor. You may not
pretty
have
similar.
Been country. You may not have been country poor like American country poor, but you were.
Yeah.
You were Southeast Asian country poor.
Oh yeah, we were pretty much the same in a lot of ways, except that the weather is different. You know, we also live kind of differently. Being in an island surroundings kind of thing. We lived in. Houses that were made of with roof that was made of palms, you know, very because we don't have the four seasons and all that, so we don't have insulation or nothing. We just a wooden hut.
Wow.
So to speak. Yeah.
quick question for you. When was your first trip to the States, and when was your first experience in Nashville?
Well, it was 1975. I went to Nashville alone, all by myself. I decided to. I had always had this love with country music and the Nashville sound, and I decided to. After a couple of years of performing and being a professional, I saved up enough money and got enough courage to take the flight over to the Nashville. In 1975, October, I remember that.
Wow. Did it really open your eyes when you got there?
Oh, yeah. Well, it was what I thought it was. You know, I when I arrived, you know, you see the big signs in Music City, USA. And, I did not know much about Nashville, the town to say, you know, so I didn't know how far things were, you know, and so what I did was I checked into one of the nearest hotel that's near to the airport, and that's not too far. I didn't know how far I was into right. Nashville town right. itself. So I checked into the Roadway Inn, and I thought that, you know, things were like in Singapore, the taxis were pretty much the same cost and all that. So I right. was pretty really not informed at all. So I jumped into, the first thing I wanted to do was to go and visit. I had been in correspondence with Fred Carter at the time when I was in Singapore. And Fred Carter wrote me a letter and told me that if I should ever be in Nashville to come visit him. And when I got there the next day, I jumped into a taxi and said, so Goodlettsville, Tennessee, from Roadway Inn, near the airport, Nashville, you know, and I did not know how far it was. And when I got into the taxi and the meter started rolling, boy, I got a real shock, you know.
The sticker shock.
The price was going up, and I was telling myself, my goodness, you know, at that time, the Singapore dollar was something like $3 to $1,
right?
You know, $1. So the meter was going up to like $20 or more US, you know, right. or thereabout.
Yeah, in 1975.
I was really getting to start to worry.
Yeah.
You know,
now,
you know, because I didn't know how far that was, but when I saw the meter, I said, my goodness, how am I going to go back? You know, is there any taxi going home, and how much has I got to pay going back, you know, in the nighttime? Because in Singapore, we have like a midnight charge. If you take a taxi after 12, you have to pay another 50% on top of the bill.
Oh, jeez.
Wow.
So, yeah, so I started to get, you know, a little anxious, a little worried.
Yeah, I bet.
Hey, Matthew, one thing that I do want to ask, and correct me if I'm wrong, but you were actually the first, you know, Asian to play at the Grand Ole Opry. Is that correct?
I did not actually play at the Grand Ole Opry on the Opry night itself.
You played on the radio.
I did a visit there with them and all that, but I played actually with them on the Midnight Jamboree and the Stub Midnight Jamboree.
Absolutely.
But yeah, we were just on the Opry because we did not give them enough notice. We were just on standby, you know, just in case some act don't appear or couldn't appear, and we would then be called upon to appear.
Wow! Now you met a lot of big names while you were there. You know, you mentioned Barbara Mandrill, Roy Acuff, Ernest Tubbs, and these folks had a great influence on you. At that time, you know, your big hit, which is Singapore Cowboy, it was written there. Do you ever get tired of hearing Singapore Cowboy?
Well, sometimes I don't get tired of listening to it. I get tired of singing it sometimes. You know, when I think back and look at all the fans who request for it, I sometimes, you know, I have to thank God and bless myself and say, look, you know, these people have come all the way and they have made me what I am. I cannot ever say no to them, you know. So although it sometimes gets to be a little stale, but I still try to do it as best as I can.
Matthew Tan, the Singapore Cowboy, joined us on the WB Morning Circus. Thanks for taking the time today.
Thank you.
Thank you, Matthew. Appreciate it.
Ah, yeah. Man, what a great... Great job, Howard, on bringing us something unique and really cool, because Matthew Tan, a great individual, a very kind man, and the Singapore Cowboy. An honor to have him on the WB Morning Circus.
It really was. Cool. You know, he said it had been 30 years since he had been on American radio.
Right on.
So well, here he is. I got high on country radio. That's cool.
That is cool. Google, YouTube. Singapore Cowboy for more details.
Right. Find a documentary on him. There is a documentary.
And get that as well. Yeah. Absolutely. I definitely want to watch now. All right. Weather forecast, community calendar on the way. KITX 5.5.
Morning, Circus.